हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज जयंत सोनकर वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी तुलसीराम जी गायकवाड़ पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट थ्रेड्स इन डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड सिस्टम एंड इट इज़ द पार्ट ऑफ सब्जेक्ट डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड सिस्टम्स। सो ऑल्दो प्रोसेस फॉर्म अ बिल्डिंग ब्लॉक इन डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड सिस्टम, इन प्रैक्टिस इंडिकेट्स दैट the granularity of the processes as provided by the operating system on which distributed systems are built is not sufficient. Instead, it turns out that having a finer granularity in the form of multiple threads of control for process makes it much easier to build distributed applications and to attain better performance. In this section, we take a closer look at the role of threads in distributed systems and explain why they are so important in the distributed system, more on threads and how they can be used to build application can be found in Lewis and Burr paper 1998 and Stevens 1999. So we will start our session with the introduction to the threads. To understand the role of threads in distributed system, it is important to understand what a process is and how processes and thread relate. To execute a program, an operating system creates a number of virtual processors, each one for running a different program. To keep track of these virtual processors, the operating system has a process table containing entries to store CPU registers values, memory maps, open files, accounting information, privileges, etc. A process is often defined as a program in execution, that is a program that is currently being executed on one of the operating system's virtual processors. An important issue is that the operating system take great care to ensure that independent processes cannot maliciously and inadequately affect the correctness of each other's behavior. In other words, the fact that multiple processes may be concurrently sharing the same CPU and other hardware resources to made transparent. Usually, the operating system required hardware support to enforce this separation. This concurrency transparency come at relatively high price. For example, each time a process is created, the operating system must create a complete independent address space. Allocation can mean initializing memory segments by, for example, zeroing a data segment, copying the associated program into text segment, and setting up a stack for memory data. Likewise, switching the CPU between two processes may be relatively expensive as well, apart from saving the CPU context, which consists of register values, program counter, stack pointer, etc. The operating system will also have to modify registers for the memory management unit, that is MMU, and invalidate address translation catches, such as in the translation look aside buffer, that is TLB. In addition, if operating system supports more processes, then it can be simultaneously hold in main memory. It may have to swap processes between main memory and disk before actual switch can take place. Like a process, a thread execute its own piece of code. Thread execute its own piece of code independently from other threads. However, in contrast to processes, no attempt is made to achieve a high degree of concurrency transparency if this would result in performance degradation. Therefore, a thread system generally maintains only a minimum information to allow a CPU to be shared by the several threads. In particular, a thread context often consists of nothing more than CPU context along with some other information for thread management. For example, a thread system may keep track of fact that a thread is currently blocked on the mutex variable so as not to select if for execution. Information that is not strictly necessary to manage multiple threads is generally ignored. For this reason, protecting data against inappropriate access by threads within a single process is left entirely to the application developer. There are two important implications for this approach. First, all the performance of the multi-threaded application need hardly ever worse than that of the single-threaded counterpart. In fact, in many cases, multi-threading lead to performance gain. Then second one is because threads are automatically protected against each other, the way processes are, development of the multi-threaded applications require additional intellectual efforts. So proper design and keeping things simple as usual help a lot. Unfortunately, current practice does not demonstrate this principle is equally well understood. Then we will see uses of thread, that is thread usage in non-distributed system. Here you can see the diagram. Before discussing the role of thread, we can say in distributed system, we first consider their uses in traditional, that is non-distributed system. There are several benefits to multi-threaded processes that we have increased the popularity of using thread systems. Thread system maintains the dependency between different cells, often from different spreadsheets. Therefore, wherever a cell is modified, all dependent cells are automatically updated. When a single or a user changes the value in a single cell, such a modification can trigger a large series of computations. If there is only a single thread of control, computation cannot proceed while the program is waiting for input. Likewise, it is not easy to provide input while dependencies are being calculated. The easy solution is to have at least two threads of control, one for handling interaction with the user and one for updating the spreadsheet. It means in the meantime, a third thread could be used for backing up the spreadsheet to disk while the other two are doing their work. Another advantage of multi-threading is that it becomes possible to exploit parallelism when executing the program on a multiprocessor system. In that case, each thread is assigned to a different CPU while shared the data are stored in shared processes. In shared main memory. When properly designed, such parallelism can be transparent. The process will run equally well on a uniprocessor system. all about slower multi-threading for parallelism is becoming increasingly important with the availability of relatively cheap multiprocessor workstation. Such computer systems are typically used for running several client-server applications. Multi-threading is also useful in the context of large applications. Such applications are often developed as a collection of operating programs and cooperating programs, each to be executed by a separate process. This approach is typically for Unix environment. Cooperation between programs is implemented by means of the inter-process communication, that is the IPC mechanism. For a Unix system, these mechanisms typically include name, that is pipes, message queues, and shared memory segment. The major drawback of IPC mechanism is that the communication often require extensive context switching. This is shown in the diagram which is given below, given here, that is context switching as the result of IPC. Because of IPC require the kernel intervention, a process will generally first have to switch from user mode to kernel mode, as shown as S1 in the diagram. This require the changing the memory map in the MMU, as well as flushing the TLB within the kernel. A process context switch take place, after which other party can be activated by switching from kernel node to user node again. Then the latter switch again require changing the MMU map and flushing the table TLB. Instead of using the processes, an application can also be constructed such that different parts are executed by separate threads. The communication between those parts is entirely dealt with using shared data. Thread switching can sometimes be done entirely in user space, although in other implementation the kernel aware of threads and schedule them. The effect can be dramatic improvement in the performance. Finally, there is also a pure software engineering reason to use the threads. Many applications are simply easier to structure as collections of corporating threads. Think of applications that need to perform several more or less independent tasks. For example, in the case of word processor, separate threads can be used for handling user input, spelling and grammar checking, document layout, index generation. So this is what the role of threads in non-distributed system. Then here we can see in this example, in non-distributed system, like in the example, the word processor, separate threads can be used for handling the user input. In the word processor, spelling will be checked and the grammar will be checked. Then document layout is proper or not, that will be checked by means of the threads. And then index generation will also be done by means of the threads. So this is all about the threads in non-distributed system. Then we will see how we will move towards the implementation of thread, how to implement the thread. So threads are often provided in the form of thread package. Such package contain operation to create and destroy threads as well, and as well as the operation on synchronization variable such as mutex and condition variables. There are basically two approaches to implement a thread package. The first approach is constructed a thread library that is executed entirely in the user mode use mode, sorry, user mode. The second approach is to have kernel be aware of threads and schedule them. A user level thread library has a number of advantages. First, it is a cheap to create and destroy thread because all the thread administration is kept in the user's address space. The price of creating thread is primarily determined by the cost of allocating memory to set up the thread stack. So destroying a thread mainly involves freeing memory for the stack, which is no longer used. Both operations are cheap operations. Then a second advantage of a user level thread is that switching thread context can be often be done in just a few instructions. Basically, only the values of the CPU registers need to be stored and subsequently reloaded with the previously stored values of the thread for which it is being switched. There is no need to change memory maps, flush the table TLB, do CPU accounting and so on. Switching thread context is done when two threads need to be synchronized, for example when entering a section as shared data. However, the major drawback of user level thread is that invocation of the blocking system calls will immediately block the entire process to which the thread belongs, and thus all the other threads is that process. As we explain, the thread are particularly useful to structure large application into parts that would be logically executed at the same time. In that case, blocking on IO should not prevent often part of executed in the meantime. For such applications, user level threads are of no help. A solution lies in hybrid from user level kernel threads, that generally referred to as a lightweight processes LWP. A LWP run the context of single heavy weight process, and there can be several LWPs processes. In addition to having the LWPs, a system also offer a user level thread package offering applications in the usual operations for creating and destroying the thread. In addition, the package provides facilities for thread synchronization such as mutex and condition variable. The important issue is that the thread package is implemented entirely in the user space. In other words, the operation of the threads are carried out without intervention of the kernel. Here in this diagram, the combining kernel level lightweight processes and user level threads scenario is given, where the user space is shown and the kernel space is shown here. So the thread package can share the multiple LWP as shown in this figure. This means that LWP can running its own user level thread. Multi-threaded applications are constructed by creating threads and subsequently signing by means of the processes. So this is about the thread which is used in user space, and it uses the LWP, that is lightweight processes. So assigning a thread to an LWP is normally implicit and hidden from the programmer. In combination of thread and LWP work as follows. The thread packages has a single routine to schedule the next thread. When creating an LWP, the The LWP is given its own stack and is instructed to execute the scheduling routine in search of the thread to examine if there are several LWPs, then each of them execute the schedule. The thread table, which is used to keep the track of the current set of threads, thus shared by the LWP. Protecting this table to guarantee mutually exclusive access is done by means of the mutex that are implemented entirely in the user space. In other words, synchronization between LWP does not require any kernel support. So this is about the implementation of thread. Then we will see multi-threaded server. So to establish a high degree of contribution transparency, distributed system that operate in wide area network may need to conceal long inter-process message propagation times. The round trip delay in wide area network can easily be in the order of hundreds of milliseconds or sometimes even seconds. The usual way to hide communication latencies is to initiate communication and immediately proceed with something else. A typical example where this happens in web browser. In many cases, a web document consists of an HTML file containing plain text along with collection of images, icons, etc. To fetch each element of web document, the browser has to set up a TCP/IP connection, read the incoming data and pass it to a display component. Setting up the connection as well as reading incoming data are inherently blocking operation. When dealing with long haul communication, we also have disadvantage that time of each operation to complete may be relatively long. So there is another important benefit to using the multi-threaded web browser, in which several connections can be open simultaneously. In the previous example, we have taken several connections were set up to same server. If that server is heavily loaded or just plain slow, no real performance improvement will be named compared to pulling in the files that make up page strictly on after the other, one after the other. However, this may case in many cases web server have been replicated across multiple machines where each server provide exactly the same set of web documents. The replicated server are located at the same site and are known as under the same name. When a request of web page came in, the request is forwarded to one of the server, and often using multi-robin strategy or some other load balancing technique. When using the multi-threaded client connection may be set up to different replicas, allowing the data to be transferred in parallel, effectively establishing that the entire web document is fully displayed in much shorter time than with the non-replicated server. This approach is possible only if the client can handle truly parallel streams of the incoming data. Thread is ideal for this purpose. Then multi-threaded server. So to understand the benefit of the threads for writing server code, consider the organization of file server that occasionally has to block waiting for the disk. The file server normally wait for an incoming request for a file operation, subsequently carries out the request and then send back the reply. One possible and particularly popular organization as shown in figure here, one thread, the dispatcher read incoming request for a file operation. The requests are sent by client as well known endpoint as well known endpoint to the server. After examining the request, the server choose an IDL. Then worker thread, servers choose an IDL worker thread and hand it and hands it the request and hand it the request. The worker proceed by performing blocking read, blocking on the local file system, which may cause the thread to be suspended until the data are fetched from disk. If thread is suspended, another thread is selected to execute it. For example, the dispatcher may be selected to acquire more work. Alternatively, another worker thread can be selected that is now ready to run. Now consider how the file server might have been written in the absence of threads. One possibly is to have it operate as a single thread. The main loop of the file server get a request, examine it and carries it out to the completion before getting the next one. While waiting for the disk, the server is IDL and does not process any other processes. Consequently, the request from other client cannot be handled. In addition, if the file server is running on the dedicated machine, as it commonly the case, the CPU is simply IDL while the file server is waiting for disk. The net result is that many fewer requests per second can be processed. This thread gain considerable performance, but each thread is programmed subsequently in the usual way. Then in this diagram, there are three ways to construct the multi-threaded server model that is given here, that is the threads, then single threaded process and finite state machines, and their characteristics are also given, that is thread model multi-threaded server having the characteristic parallelism, blocking system calls, etc., and then single threaded process having the characteristics no parallelism, blocking system calls, and then finite state machine model that is having the parallelism, non-blocking system calls, etc. So this is all about the threads in the distributed system. Thank you.